give you to us for our mother. You are the kindest, the most loving of all mothers. Look tenderly on us, your children, as we now ask you to help us in all our needs, especially this one. While you were on earth, dear Mother, you willingly shared in the sufferings of your Son. Strengthened by your faith and confidence in the fatherly love of God, you accepted the mysterious designs of His will. We too have our crosses and trials. Sometimes they almost crush us to the ground. Dearest Mother, share with us your abundant faith and confidence in God. Make us aware that God never ceases to love us, that He answers all our prayers in the way that is best for us. Strengthen our hearts to carry the cross in the footsteps of your divine Son. Help us to realize that he who shares the cross of Christ will certainly share his resurrection. Dearest Mother, as we worry about our own problems, let us not forget the needs of others. You always love others so much. Help us to do the same. While praying for our own intentions and for the intentions of all here present at this novena, we earnestly ask you, our Mother, to help us comfort the sick and the dying, give hope to the poor and the unemployed, heal the brokenhearted, walk in solidarity with the oppressed, teach justice to their oppressors, and bring back to God all those who have offended Him. Dearest Mother, help us to avoid sin which separates us from our Heavenly Father and from one another. Full of trust in you, we place ourselves under the mantle of your maternal protection and confidently hope for your compassionate intercession. Amen. Prayer for the home. Mother of perpetual help, we choose you as queen of our homes. We ask you to bless all our families with your tender motherly love. May the sacrament of marriage bind husbands and wives so closely together that they will always be faithful to each other and love one another as Christ loved his church. We ask you to bless all parents. May they love and cherish the children whom God has entrusted to them. May they always give them the example of a truly Christian life. Help them to bring up their children in the love and fear of God. Bless all children that they may love, honor, and obey their fathers and mothers. For your loving care, we specially entrust the youth of today. Give us all a sense of responsibility that we may do our part in making our home a haven of peace like your own home at Nazareth. We take you as our model. Help us to grow daily in genuine love of God and neighbor so that justice and peace may happily reign in the entire family of mankind. Amen. Petitions to our Mother of Perpetual Help, Holy Mary, pray for us. Holy Virgin conceived without sin, pray for us. Our Mother of Perpetual Help, pray for us. We sinners call to you, loving Mother, pray for us, that we may prepare like you for the coming of Christ. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for men. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be more and more like our Divine Lord as you were. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son, Jesus. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may fear losing God's friendship forever by unrepented sin. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may see Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of daily life. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in moments of temptation. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may understand the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may grow in the love of Christ and neighbor by frequent communion. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may strive to be true Christians by our loving concern for others. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may forgive from our heart those who have wronged us. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may see the evil of seeking our own interests at the expense of others. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may share our talents with others for the good of the community. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service. Loving Mother, pray for us, that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and the clergy. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be blessed with an increase in priestly and religious vocations. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may care and protect God's creation. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may defend the human dignity and sanctity of human life from conception to natural death. Loving Mother, pray for us, that there will be genuine and lasting peace in the world. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know Him. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be aware of our dependence in God in the midst of human achievements. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord. Loving Mother, pray for us, that our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection. Loving Mother, pray for us. Let us pray in silence for our own intention. Holy Mary, pray for us. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience God's perpetual help. Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to have recourse to her in all our needs. Amen. Thanksgiving Prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, truly present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. It has pleased the Father that in you all his fullness should dwell, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we may be truly sorry for our sins and renew our lives. Through you, we thank the Eternal Father for the gift of life. He has created all the wonderful things of this world for us. May we learn to use them well, so that through them, we may grow in love for Him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of His love, to save us and all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own mother to be our mother of perpetual help. May the countless favors we have received through her intercession, and especially through the novena, inspire us with greater confidence in God's loving mercy and perpetual help. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God and persevere in His love. To the Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be honor, glory, and thanksgiving forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, You bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows in order to show us clearly the value of human weakness and patience. Graciously hear our prayer for the sick. Grant that they who are weighed down with pain and other afflictions of illness may experience God's healing power and comfort. Restore them to health in body and soul so that they can continue to serve you and their brothers and sisters. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Today is Wednesday of the second week of Advent. Our Mass presider is Reverend Father Siegfried Arellano. Please all stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the secret mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who command us to prepare the way for Christ the Lord, grant in your kindness, we pray, that no infirmity may weary us as we long for the comforting presence of our heavenly physician, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. To whom can you liken me as an equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who has created this thing. He leads out their army and numbers them, calling them all by name. By his great might and the strength of his power, not one of them is missing. Why, O Jacob, do you say and declare, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Do you not know, or have you not heard? The Lord is the eternal God, creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint nor grow weary, and his knowledge is beyond his scrutiny. He gives strength to the fainting. For the weak, he makes vigor abound. Though young men faint and grow weary, and youths stagger and fall, they that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar as with eagle's wings. They will run and not grow weary, walk and not grow faint. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O bless the Lord, my soul.
O bless the Lord, my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
O bless the Lord, my soul.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
O bless the Lord, my soul.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
O bless the Lord, my soul. Please all stand. Alleluia, alleluia. Behold, the Lord comes to save his people. Blessed are those prepared to meet him.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Brothers and sisters, today God assures us that with and in Him, life is bearable and life is meaningful. He alone can and will come to help and save us. Lalapit po tayo sa Kanya. Yun ang sinasabi, mga kapatid, sa atin sa mga pagbasang ito. Lalapit tayo sa ating Panginoong Diyos. Magtiwala po tayo sa Kanya, dahil Siya ay patuloy, at nandyan Siya na handa tumulong po sa atin. They that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar as with eagle's wings. They will run and not grow weary. Walk and not grow faint. So, the words in the first reading, ito ay galing sa ating Panginoong Diyos. And Jesus implores us also in the Gospel, "Come to me, all you who work hard and who carry burdens, and I will give you rest." Siguro marami sa atin, brothers and sisters, in our everyday life, parang pagod na po tayo. Maraming mga mabibigat na mga pangyayari, mga problema, kung ano-ano pa dumarating sa buhay natin. And sometimes, we feel so hard, to bear these things, na sunod-sunod na dumarating sa buhay po natin. So these words of Jesus is really a word of hope. Brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus Christ invites us today to take His yoke and to learn from His gentleness and humility. Never lose trust in God's benevolent love and care for us. God never abandoned His people. Tandaan po natin yan. He assured the prayers of His people, Israel. He answered the prayer of His people, Israel. He saved them. Mga kapatid, tinutulungan po sila ng ating Panginoong Diyos. Sila sa kanilang pagkaalipin, ng kanilang kaaway, sa kanilang pagdurusa, bunga ng kanilang kasalanan. Ngunit hindi sila pinababayaan ng Diyos. Kung sila'y nagsisisi, lalapit sa Diyos, nandoon lang siya, handang tumulong sa kanyang bayang Israel. So the good news is, God loves His people. God loves us. Let us never forget that the powerful God is our loving Father, who always cares for us. Now with Jesus, the heavy challenges and burdens of our life now will always be bearable, even good and light. So I hope that this Eucharist today now will give us again the strength at tatanggap tayo ng biyaya na narinig natin na itong promesa ng Panginoong Hesukristo ay talagang ibigay niya po sa atin. And also today, brothers and sisters, it's also a special day for me because today is my third sacerdotal anniversary sa pandemic na ito. Wala tayong mga dito lang, the Eucharist. So, ang importante ay mga kapatid ay nakikita, nakikita ko talaga yung tulong ng Diyos. Kahit sa 3 taon, para sa akin parang ang tagal na. Imagine, Father Andy, 20 years. Kaya nga, I need your prayers. I need your prayers. Kasama ko na ordained, ipagdasal din po ninyo. Sana po, huwag nyo kaming kalimutan. Hinihingi ko po sa inyo. Please pray for us. Si Father Joel Bonina, si Father Riel Palmario, and Father Aidan Sabaliero. So, iba-ibang misyon. Yung isa sa Bicol, isa sa Mindanao, dalawa kami po dito sa Manila. So, I always, every time na may problema or every time na nahihirapan po ako sa aking ministry, inalaala ko lang ang yung palagi ang sinasabi ni Cardinal Tagle, yung homily niya po sa during our ordination. Sabi niya po sa kanyang homily, the formation or the foundation of true service and ministry is the love of Christ. Yun lang. Yan lang ang foundation, the love of Christ. And being a priest means being humble servant of the Lord. So, Jesus will remain the shepherd and we should not take over. Yun ang sinabi niya. You should not take over. Jesus is the shepherd. You just feed the sheep. Yun lang ang trabaho ng isang pari. To feed the sheep. So, priesthood, sabi niya, do not forget that priesthood is mission and not ambition. So, kaya nga, yun palagi ko tinatandaan. At sa tulong po ninyo, salamat po sa inyong support, sa inyong prayers, sa inyong encouragement, sa kay Father Andy, dahil mula pagdikon ko hanggang pagkapari ko hanggang ngayon, nandito pa rin ako. So sana na-transfer na siguro ako kung walang COVID. So nandito pa rin ako ngayon. So salamat po sa inyong prayers, sa inyong support. Sana po huwag niyo kaming kalimutan na mga pari, idala, please include us in your prayers. Yan yung aming lakas. Salamat.
Please all stand.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest." Confident of this promise, we now present to him our needs. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Father and the bishops of the Church may guide us in the ways of peace and reconciliation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are tempted to despair under the crushing weight of their problems may seek refuge in Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are suffering from mental torment may find peace in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are weighed down by bodily pain and illness may find comfort and healing in the care and concern of those who nurse them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may find eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son promised to give us rest whenever burdened. Grant that we may always respond to His guidance and strengthen us to be instruments of His peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to your unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty in our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for He assumed at His first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when He comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body in the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz and companions, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Sama
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you. Sa ngalan po ng Archdiocese ng Maynila at nitong Minor Basilica at National Shrine ni San Lorenzo Ruiz, pinabati po si Reverend Father Joseph Marisig Villarillano sa kanyang 3rd taon bilang pari. Sa ngalan ng Archdiocese at nitong Minor Basilica, salamat Father Siegfried sa pagbibigay ng sarili bilang pari. Patuloy po natin siyang ipagdasal, panatiling pari, kabanalan at mga bukod-tanging biyaya na kailangan niya sa kanyang pagkapari. Happy anniversary po muli, Father Siegfried. Palakpakan po natin si Father Siegfried.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feast through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Lord bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.